Hi friends, welcome to Java coding interview questions. So in this video we are going to see how to read a n by n matrix from user. Okay, so what we'll be doing is we'll take the number of rows for a matrix and number of column from the matrix and the elements we want to store in that matrix, and we'll finally display that matrix. Okay, so these are the steps which we are going to do. Okay, what is the how to read a n by n matrix from the user? This is one of the important program. So by at the end of this program we are going to learn, so how do we read the data from the console or the keyboard, and at the same time how to create and initialize a two-dimensional array, at the same time how to display the elements in a two-dimensional array. So these are the concepts we are going to learn, as well as by executing this program or by coding this program. So first, what is the step? In the first step, what we are going to do is, read the number of rows. This is the first step. What is the first step? Number of rows we are going to read. And then we are going to read the number of columns for a matrix. Okay. And then the third step, once we have rows and columns for the matrix, what we can do, we can enter the elements for the matrix. Enter the elements for the matrix. And finally, display the elements in the matrix. Okay, these are the four steps. So the first, I'm going to create a class. And in this class, what I'm going to create? I'm saying it as matrix. Matrix demo. And I'm writing a main method. So suppose if I want to create a 2x2 matrix, so first what I'll do, I'll read the number of rows. What are the number of rows? 2. Okay, and what are the number of columns? 2. And the elements are, suppose I want to store 1, 2, 3, 4 is the elements. Okay, how it gets represented? (1, 2, 3, 4) like this. And finally, when we display, it should get displayed like this. Okay, so this is the requirement. So first thing what we are going to do is, so we are going to create a, so as we are trying to read the values using keyboard or from the console, Eclipse console, what we are going to do is, we are going to create a scanner object. Okay, scanner equal to new scanner of system.in. So this system.in is used to read the input from the keyboard. Okay, so since we don't have the scanner, I'm importing it from the java.util package. So what this scanner does, this scanner is used to pass the incoming data, okay, which is read through the command line. I can open the scanner class and show you the documentation as well. What is the purpose of the scanner? So it is a simple scanner which can parse primitive types and strings using the regular expressions. So what this scanner does is, it breaks the input into tokens using a delimiter pattern. Which pattern? Delimiter pattern. So this is the scanner. Scanner equal to new scanner of system.in. And then I'm going to, first what we are going to enter? Enter the number of rows in a matrix, and then so I'm just representing the rows with m, or just it would be better if I use it r, and columns for c. Okay, so rows and columns, so I'm defining r equal to 0 and then columns equals to, just I am initializing with the 0. Okay, first I am just trying to initialize the, so I am just defining rows and columns by using integer. Okay, we are using the data type int, int r comma c. So now what I am doing is r equal to in dot next, sorry, r equal to scanner dot next int. So we are taking the rows from the console by using the keyboard, and I am just saying c scanner dot next int. So I'm just writing one sysout so that we'll understand what is second. I'm just adding one system.out.println. So when we say first scanner dot next int, we'll get one second. So first we are entering the number of rows in a matrix, and then we are calling r equal to scanner dot next int. In the similar way, I'm just adding one more sysout so that we'll understand what is happening. And I'm saying enter the number of columns in a matrix. Okay, first we are getting the number of rows, and then we got the number of columns. So now we are going to do, we are creating a array. So how do you create an array? So int, I'm just saying matrix array, array equal to new int of rows, column, columns. So what is the two-dimensional array which we are going to create? It should be equal to the number of rows and the number of columns in the matrix. So that is the reason I'm using int matrix equal to new int of rc. So this is how we create an two-dimensional array in Java. Now what I'm trying to do is I'm entering the number of elements. Enter the elements of the matrix. So after creating the array, what we need to do? We need to store the values into the matrix. Okay, or enter. So how do we do that? So first what I'm saying is, so in order to store each and every, in order to store a value in a matrix at the particular position, what we need to do, we need to loop through the array and store it in the particular index. So first what I am doing, I equal to 0, I less than m, I plus plus. Okay, so this I is for rows. Okay, so we are looping through the row, first row, second row and third row. And then we are adding one more loop, and I'm saying int j equal to 0. So it's not I less than m, it is I less than r. Okay, I equal to 0, I less than r, I plus plus. Int j equal to 0, j less than c, j less than c and j plus plus. I'm just adding one more loop here. So this is for the number of rows and this is for the number of columns. Okay, so now what we are going to do, first we are looping through the rows, and inside that rows, suppose if I want to store, the loop starts at 0. At 0 comma 0, I want to store the element 1. So how do I store that element 1? At a 0 comma 0 position. So first I need to loop through this, starting with 0 with the number of rows. Okay, and at the same time, I need to start with the 0 and loop through the columns. Now what I am going to do, I am going to say matrix of I, j, equal to in dot next, in is nothing but, this is a scanner actually, in is nothing but scanner. So I'm just saying scanner dot next int. So whatever the value we are reading, we are storing in I and J. Okay, so hope you understand this is how we store. So this logic is very important. Okay, this is the logic of code for storing the values in a matrix. So first I value will be what? 0. Okay, and then J value will be 0. So suppose we are creating a 2 by 2 matrix and storing elements in a 2 by 2 matrix. So in that case, I will be starting with the 0 and rows will be 2. So I less than 2. So is 0 less than 2? True. What happens? It will enter this loop. And now what it will check for int j is equals to 0. So it will check what are the number of columns? 2 columns. So it will check 0 is less than 2 or not. Is it true? Correct. So now what we'll be storing is whatever the value we are reading from the command line, we are storing it in 0 comma 0th position. Okay. So at 0 comma 0 position for the first iteration, what we are going to do? 0 comma 0 element, we are storing 1. And then J value gets incremented. Now J will becomes what in the second loop? 1. Okay. So int J equal to 1. J less than C. So that is 1 less than 2. Is it true? Correct. So now what will happen? I will be 0 and J will be 1. So at 0 comma first position we are storing value, whatever the value we are entering from the keyboard, which is 2. Okay. So this is how we do. And first 0 comma 0 is done. 0 comma 1 is done. So what is the next one? Okay. 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2. So this is how we does actually for storing the values in a matrix. So how do we display the values of a matrix? So just we need to, in a similar way, you need to print the each and every element at that particular index. Okay. So I'll explain you here also what we need to do in order to print a 2-dimensional 2 by 2 matrix. What we need to do? We need to have two loops, int I equal to 0, I less than R, I plus plus, and int J equal to 0, J less than C, J plus plus. So in before this loop, what I'm trying to do, I'm saying displaying the elements in the matrix. So what I'm saying, system.out.println, what we are trying to print? Matrix of I and J. I'm just adding spaces. First we'll print the first element. Okay, so first what we are trying to do, int I will be 0. So 0 less than 2, true. Okay, so here for the first loop I will be 0 and then J equal to 0. Here J will be initialized to 0 and then J less than C. So 0 less than 2. Is it true? Correct. Now what we are going to do? We are printing the value which is at 0 comma 0 position. What we are trying to do? Matrix of 0 comma 0th position. So this is how we read the elements from a matrix and display or print the elements in a matrix. So why I added this space? So while printing the elements, right, it should display the spaces after each element. Okay, so that is the reason. So after that, one more system.out.println. I'm just saying with system.out.println. I'm just giving empty. So what happens? So this, what is the purpose of this is, so once entering one row and one column, what happens? This line will get executed and again j will be incremented. Okay, so that is the reason. I'm just running the program and showing the output. Okay, first, what is the number of rows? I'm saying 2. Enter. And then what I'm trying to do? Entering the number of columns. And now I'm entering 2. Now what I'm trying to do? I'm trying to store the elements in a matrix. Okay, so what I'm trying to do? 1. Okay, I have entered the first element. And then 2, second element. And I am entering 3, third element. I am entering 4, fourth element. So for 2 by 2 matrix, we will be having 2 rows and 2 columns. Okay, so totally 4 elements will be there. So I have entered the 4 elements. Now when I click enter, it should display 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, actually these 3 and 4 should be displayed. Okay, in the vertical, but it displayed, instead of displaying in the matrix, okay, it has entered the space and entered, it has given the 3, 4. This is because of this system.out.println. Okay, let me correct this system.out.println. So just I'm executing the program again to just check the output. So enter the number of rows in the matrix, it is 2. And enter the number of columns in the matrix, it's 2 again. And then now I'm entering the values 1, 2, 3, 4. If you see, after 1 and 2, there is a space and 3, 4. Actually, this 2 should come here and this 3 should come here and 4 should be here. But what is happening is every time whenever we enter that, whenever we are printing the value, it is printing in the new line. Okay, so the culprit here is this ln statement. So what the system.out.println will do, it will print each and every character in a new line. So instead of that, what we need to do, we need to use system.out.print here. Okay, so what happens is instead of printing in the new line, it will print on the same line. Let's run the program and see the output. I'm entering 2, enter the number of columns, again 2, enter the elements in the matrix. So I'm entering 4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. You see, so it is displayed as a matrix 1, 2 and 3, 4. Okay, hope you understand this program. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.